You need some accessories, bitch. You are tired. What are those braids? You look like a roach. Why you so fast?
Bitch, the question was for me.
Chill.
Girl, it's giving me clearance section, girl. It's giving me all.
But hey, both y'all.
Girl, you look like my bodyguard.
Chill. Can you chill? Chill.
That was inferior, bitch.
Cause you pussy. Yeah, you pussy. You was gonna smack me, but you didn't. Yeah.
All right.
Girl, shut up. Wait for the actual segment. Cause the only time you got any camera time is talk about me, right?
That's why you press. That's all you do.
You talking now. Nobody was talking to you, girl.
All right.
Hey.
Cut it down. I'm trying to host this show right now, and y'all have kept this going for way too long. You read, we're done.
Who they was rooting for, who they would like to see. But where my work's concerned, baby, that work is done. Tell these motherfuckers what I do. I get it pop, it's pop, it's pop.
Throw this pop for 40 seconds.
It's pop, it's pop.
Throw this pop for 40 seconds.
It's pop, it's pop.
Throw this pop for 40 seconds.
We're done. We good?
She didn't read good. Shit.
Got my bang all messed up right now.
Got my bang.
Relax, dude.
Shit, I'm like over here. Y'all are yelling.
She interrupted talk to her.
I get it. But let's continue.
Was it a question for me?
I have a question for you.
I thought it was.
Totally different. Okay.
Girl, sit in your place. You're not even on the cast.
Jesus. All right. Now, Eugene.
Can I answer the question?
Okay, I mean, did you?
He was cut off.
I thought you did answer the question.
Like, is this the whole reunion?
All right, give me a second.
I like structure.
Give me a second.
Mel.
Yes.
All right.
Let's get some structure.
Yeah. Come on.
Y'all had me yell today. Oh my God.
Interrupt for a motherfucker.
I lost all the curls, bitch.
Now, were you jealous? You know, when Tevin asking Dante on a date.
Absolutely not. Me and Dante are friends. We were friends. We were spending time together, whatever, but me and Dante ain't got nothing to do with him and Tevin. Apparently, Tevin got a boyfriend, so I don't understand how they would be jealous.
All right.
Tevin ain't even my pinky toe bitch.
Okay, all right, and next question.
It just don't make
sense. And next question.
Yeah, let's move on.
All right, okay.
She don't even have to file taxes.
All right, now Eugene, you wanted to play peacemaker.
Stop.
Would you do it again?
Absolutely not.
Please don't.
You should. Absolutely not. I wasn't there, but I was, you know, it was an awful situation. I didn't know his people. I heard it was a little issue. I felt like they could have fixed it. We're all adults. Obviously, they couldn't. People won't let other people talk. So, absolutely not. I'm not my brother.
Okay. Listen, sometimes it's just best to just sit back. Baby. All right, now, Martell.
Hey.
Did you think Jewel held her own in that conversation?
Not at all.
Absolutely.
Oh, please, Jewel.
Okay. That's it?
Absolutely.
Girl, all right.
Girl, she the hell.
All right,
weird.
Now we're going to.
Okay, so let's see here. Now, Mulatto, earlier you mentioned to production that you wanted to play an audio recording. Do you have that recording?
Tevin, stop giving so much, girl, for I get up. You are annoying me. You giving too much fever for me. Relax, because you coming off as a threat. And bitch, I don't play that shit. So calm the fuck down with the way you looking over here. And I'm gonna say,
bitch,
what?
Bitch, what?
Bitch, what? Bitch, what? Bitch, what? You extra, bitch, shut the fuck up. Stop fucking looking over here. It's as simple as that. What you gotta do? Get up so you can sit in the back.
Who the fuck are you to tell me what the fuck I can do with my eyes?
Shut the fuck up. I'm telling you. Relax, bitch.
I'm telling you.
Your raggedy ass. You thought you gonna keep looking at me like you fucking
ain't
stupid,
ain't nobody
bitch.
Looking at you, bitch.
Okay, so keep it that way, bitch.
What
you don't even look over here
you
at all,
bitch. Questions for me.
Shut up.
What? I'm so
you
sorry.
You questions for me, Maddie?
Well.
You ain't that bitch. Fucking retarded.
Okay.
You don't even got a car, girl. You drive.
I don't.
Yeah, what do you drive?
Oh.
Oh, okay, that's what I thought. Say it out loud. Okay.
Do you think that Jewel held her own in that conversation?
Yeah,
could you please elaborate?
Cars, y'all broke asses.
Yeah. Everybody's broke.
Y'all are, bitch, for real.
Who is y'all?
Stop acting like y'all. Who is y'all? I'm talking to them. If you trying to get a situation,
no. I'm not
talking.
I don't have no situation with you. When you say y'all, you're talking to everybody. And I said that earlier. Y'all gotta stop with the y'all shit. Blow the smoke in the direction it's supposed to go in.
You want something with me. I'm not talking to you.
Baby, you don't want that with me.
I made it clear.
You don't want that with me. You and nobody else don't want that with me. But stop with the y'all shit. That's all I'm saying.
Mega.
Address who you need to address.
You don't want to have a situation. I didn't say your name.
Hold on. Y'all come to me.
I hate confrontation, so this is like killing me. So I'm like just, like everybody, Wusa. I get it. I understand.
Let the show go.
Oh, my God.
We got more to come.
The next interruption, I got to take y'all.
You issues with me that I don't have an issue with.
We'll address the issues now. Make sure when they get to Mega, they don't say y'all and they don't call me no girls and stuff, because I'm not with that
Mega,
shit.
Mega, nobody was talking to
you. I get that, but you made a general statement.
I was talking to him.
We got to move forward.
I'm great. He just made a general statement.
I was saying y'all. Mega, you.
Hello. If he do not ask you a question, do not talk. Please. Thank you. Come on, man.
Mulatto, earlier you mentioned to production that you wanted to play an audio recording. Do you have that recording with you today?
I do, but now it's not the appropriate time to play.
Why not?
Because
I mean, okay, I understand. If you got a bullet in the holster now, you know, you can spin and, okay, listen, but all right. Tavin, do you feel that Melly B was trying to have too much control over the group?
No, I think he tried to control different dynamics, but not over the entire group. He wanted things his way. If it wasn't his way, then that's where the problem happened.
I'm going to ask a question that is not going to cause any issues, unless y'all are just competitive. Who here can roll the fastest blunt? I mean, I would say me. I'm not even in the cast, but like, you? I don't know, I can do it in the dark. Well, the car's on going in this dark, baby. Like, I can make it happen. Like, we hitting it today. Bitch, got my knees on the wheel, honey, okay? You ate a cookie on set, all right.
Okay, give me the gift.
Thank you. Okay, now listen, Martell, hey baby, you crashed Melly B's party. Why do you think Mulatto was ignoring you?
Can we discuss it? It was real simple. Ultimately, it was a situation where I had noticed something on Mulatto. I went to ask Tevin for advice as a man. He was like, you know, I can't really say. I asked Jewel because she was a woman. She said that she had also noticed it, but it was really nothing that we could do about it. Yeah. When she wasn't speaking to me, I had no idea, no understanding, because nothing happened. I didn't think it was that deep. Once we talked about it, I was like, this isn't that deep. I just didn't understand why we didn't discuss it.
Has it carried?
Okay, is it my turn?
Gotcha. Yeah. Go ahead, babe.
Okay, so I just want to say that every night up until then, or every day, every time we had all got together, it was just like drama. Mm. My problem was that he had a conversation with everyone else about it, but him and his fiance's boyfriends, his two boyfriends, they wanted to double date or...
It would have been one of them, yeah. It would have been a double date, technically.
Like, they wanted to,
two dates.
Five-way. They wanted to, you know, all five of us go hang out and, you know, come to our house and stuff like that. And I just kind of felt like, well, damn, you want to come to my house, you want to hang out and stuff like that. But you telling everybody else, I even inboxed Tevin, and I'm like, damn, Tevin, fellow Virgo, like, help us out, you know, leave me hanging like that or whatever. Okay. And he was like, no, like, it's not like that. You know, I didn't know how to tell you or what to say or whatever. And I just felt like I had been nice to everyone else. I gave no one, like Alyssa said earlier, she felt like some people were kind of intimidating. I didn't give that off to anyone for you not to be able to come and tell me to be like, hey, you know, your shit's a little off, or your titties are showing, or your wig's a little shifted, or whatever the case. I'm not gonna be offended. Thank you for helping me out, because I want all of us to look our best on camera. So that was my thing.
Okay.
At least tell me. You had a conversation with everybody else except for me.
Yeah, and to be clear, because I don't want to be disrespectful, because I knew, again, I had just met her 2 days prior, yeah. And then she's also a woman.
Mm-hmm.
So I know as a man speaking to a woman, I'm very conscious about how I say things, and I don't know how. And I was like, oh, hey, girl, blah, blah, blah. Like, oh, yeah. First of all, you don't fucking know me. So I was like, let me ask my friend first. And
like,
then he was like, you know, I'm a man, so I don't really know. So I was like, let me ask a woman. Right. But at that point, again, there wasn't anything that I could necessarily do to be like, oh, well, let's fix this. And this is true. I could have, but again, as a man, I didn't want to address the situation to you as a woman.
Just a little overthinking. That's all. Just a little overthinking. And, you know, you're trying to be respectful. But, you know, we got that. Okay, now later we'll discuss the retreat house drama. But up next, Alyssa shares her experience with not being invited to the ball. And we'll touch on and on and off beef between Tevin and Melly B. Stay tuned.
Is this the highlight?
It shouldn't be.
He is not my nigga. However, to be doing that is the problem if I was to take you seriously. Okay. So it wasn't a problem for me. And it wasn't a...
Let me finish talking.
Like I said, it's not a moment. It's the truth. Dante, you want to
come on? Melly, just come on.
And I'm feeling good.
I don't initiate, but I will follow up.
It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
The group dated each other with a speed dating event hosted by Mulatto and Rico. Besides Cash going in on Dante, what was your best moments from that?
I think my best moment was everybody talking to each other. Like, even though people had problems with each other and stuff like that, like, I was still making them rotate. Although it was Rico's event and I kind of took over because he was late, but I mean, you know, as you see, he don't show up, but I just took an initiative. I'm an initiative type of person. I like to see things fail. So I was like, okay, well, let's rotate. I can put little cute little icebreaker little things in there so they can have like a conversation or something like that. And I thought it was good. Even Melly and Jewel talked, Melly and Tevin.
I feel like that was a highlight for everybody. That's when we actually got along, turned up, had a good time. I think, hell, we were smoking the same blunt. So, bitch, you don't get no closer. Okay.
Well, somebody passed?
It was during COVID. Well,
yeah, let me ask these questions over here. Did y'all enjoy yourselves? Was that fun time? Like, what was the favorite part of that?
We live in the past.
It was cool. You know what? Alyssa, you brought a friend, Tristan. And Tristan was a joy. Yeah. She was super bubbly. I'm like, bitch, you didn't be in the cast. Like, I feel like she really worked the room. I feel like I enjoyed her the most of the event.
Damn, girl.
Okay, Mega.
I enjoyed just hanging out with everybody, honestly. It was good music, good vibes. I enjoyed seeing everybody.
Okay.
Even though all of them were late. And it's rare that I'm on time on the first time there.
Okay, Alyssa, what about you, baby?
It was good to see a glimpse of everyone's life.
Okay. I love it. Tevin?
We had a good time. We all danced and took pictures and talked. It was fun. It was a good time.
Pink brown?
Yeah, it was good to see everybody get along.
What was your favorite moment, baby?
It was, you know, because it was speed dating, so the questions were kind of geared towards the nasty side. It was interesting just to see, because everyone is so different. And so it's interesting to see how we got along, you know, trying to play like we trying to get to know each other. But everybody was getting along. We were smoking. We had a good time. There were situations, but I feel like that was the moment where everybody didn't have a cause to run behind. So it was a little different. It was just kind of like we here trying to get to know each other. After that is when lines started being drawn and stuff like that. So that's when it was open. And I felt like I could walk past anybody.
Was it? I thought it was
going
to be a rebirth.
Well, let me ask this, because I know Cash and Dante, y'all had a moment, but outside of that, Cash, what was your favorite moment?
Just drinking and smoking with everybody. Yeah, I at the time, you know.
I enjoyed his life.
I think, you know, it's a little unorthodox to have two boyfriends, but I got to date him, and I think one of his boyfriends there, it was a dark and foggy night. And I think it wasn't that we got along. I think the liquor and the weed brought a real good atmosphere. And I think that was like the Last Supper of the show.
Ooh, the Last Supper, a biblical reference.
It was a nice supper.
I'm gonna ask you, Dante, back here, again, outside of whatever happened, again, was this the favorite part of it? With a little smoke, a little drink, a little something, something?
Yeah, it was pretty lit. I mean, I wish I could have met more people besides the cast, because I wasn't really trying to talk to them.
Oh, please, man.
We all you need.
I can't talk to you, don't worry.
I can't. All right. Now, let's see here. Dante, you felt that Melly B being extra when he blocked you over a gang. Explain to us this crazy flirtatious relationship.
What's a gang?
You can't even talk about.
That is not why John Fick was blocked.
Oh, then what was he blocked for then?
Oh.
Yeah, what was
blocked? Y'all never played the game, but you was blocked over that rooftop.
Well, let's talk about it. Let's go ahead.
I'm asking y'all the questions. I wasn't on the cast with you.
When we came upstairs, they was talking about hoes.
But I'm going to tell you why. It's because I brought that spirit in because everybody knows what
my spirit is.
Yeah, I brought their whole spirit.
Booty hole first?
You know, and I, a lot of them don't know me. And some of them know me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm always this way.
Okay.
I have sexual humor. And yet, a lot of people on the show are very sexual creatures as well. So they deem it as somebody was going to the bathroom. That's all you were. Somebody, you wanted to go in the bathroom too, probably. And you probably don't. I like to bring laughter to uncomfortable things that people really actually fucking do. So if I'm at a kickback, now we're not at church, y'all. So stop playing with me. So if I'm at a kickback and they play Mary fucking Kill, I'm gonna say I wanna fuck Marcel, blah, blah. I'm gonna kill da da da. And I'm gonna be giving my honest answer. I'm not gonna sit there and say, oh no, the camera's rolling. You know. And then first of all, especially with the line of work that I do, that was my way of being comfortable with everybody else. And then everybody else started talking about nasty shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If only the wires could be played by a lot of mouths at night.
Well.
At the end of the day, the fuck was on Dante and they were talking about what it do, what the hole looked like. Is it loose? Is it close? Is it tight? Is it something?
Oh, but they've seen the video.
Oh, y'all wanted specifics. All right, for this jacked conversation.
Well, why wait until later on? It's a bathroom.
Right.
Come on. Why wait?
I was like, it's a bathroom. No.
But all along the way,
we were not
Dante
that.
Was trying to connect with Melly.
So that's what's the problem.
Oh.
For me, I didn't block Dante. Dante blocked me and then I blocked him. I didn't block him.
Look at that, everybody.
Issue was is anybody that you may be talking to or whatever, if y'all are at a different level, there's a certain level of respect you should have in general.
Mm.
This is my home. He is not my nigga. However, to be doing that is the problem if I was to take you seriously.
Okay.
So it wasn't a problem for me. And it wasn't a... Let me finish talking. Like I said, it's not a moment. It's the truth. Dante, you want to
come on? Melly, just come on. Finish.
Finish it.
I know that's
finish, Melly, finish.
Melly, finish it, baby. Come on.
Bitch, that's the wrong bus.
Come on, Melly, finish it, baby.
The point is, because he was trying to seriously have a situation, not seriously, but we were getting to know each other, whatever, for him to do that, it was a problem, but it wasn't a problem to where I need to react to it in a moment. He not my nigga. It ain't like I caught my man. I ain't talking about going to the bathroom. That's not what it was.
Yeah.
However, don't say that you trying to come at me and you doing that. That don't make sense to me. And so I did stop talking to Dante immediately. Like I said, it wasn't that serious. So yeah, I didn't cut him off, but it's too many niggas in line. I don't have time for that. And so, you know, it was simply just that. And so no, I did not block Dante. Dante blocked me first. So that's true.
But they also left and went home together.
Well, that's because Dante waited by the door as I was leaving the property.
Together.
Hold on, me and Dante, because I was leaving the property.
What you said,
and
pause. Wait. Well, now I got the giggles. Mulatto, would you stop?
Oh, all the details.
That's her problem.
She's like, no, that was that morning, though. But okay.
Okay, so that night,
I was like, we're gonna tell the truth.
She got all the facts. But technically, it was another day. It was after midnight, so it was a whole other day. It wasn't the same day.
But she had nothing.
Okay.
But I was walking out of the premises, and Dante was like, where you going? So we ended up going out to the gay club, and it was a straight night. So he was socially awkward. He didn't know how to be with the straighties. So
then
we left, and we went back to his room, and
Please tell it all since you got
it. No, we will not tell it all.
Not no,
let's not tell it all.
Let's cut it off. And we slept in the bed together, but we did not have sex, you know? And,
Anything
else you want?
No,
you want me to wake it up?
No, we do not want you to wake it up.
I know, I wouldn't even want me to wake it up.
No, I'm not,
I know, I wouldn't do you like that.
Why you cutting it off now, Mulatto?
I know, I wouldn't.
She had every other detail a second ago.
Is there coffee involved?
Like, you didn't even see any details.
Honestly, Dante's my friend, and I think over time, that's just what it's going to be. I couldn't even make a joke about something like that.
Okay.
But I feel like I'm going to keep it to myself.
Oh, okay. All right, y'all, listen. Now, before we discuss this as a group, the producers wanted to allow Alyssa and Jewel the chance to speak alone. Let's take a break and let's have them on the stage.
But my whole thing is I really didn't like what she said, and I feel like she should fix that shit. Mm-hmm. So I think it's unfair that she can't face the world because she don't want to sit with certain people, but everybody didn't have a problem with her.
We get it just as hard.
Absolutely. So just as, you do not get it just as hard as
we get
it
hard.
Person.
We live in the same country. We get it hard. I'm actually way below you being trans. Yes, I get it way harder than you.
Gender is different. I do agree for that as a cis person. Absolutely.
So let's keep
it talking about, no, we're going to keep it moving when I'm ready to keep it moving. Because race and ethnicity is very different.
Mm-hmm.
So people can be white Mexicans. So we're not going to say who's at the bottom of the totem pole. We're not going to do that. We're not going to do oppression Olympics.
You're looking at an icon, yeah, you're looking at a motherfucking icon. Yep. Write it down, take a picture, Nikon. Heard the motherfucker talking through the grapevine. Uh-huh. Tell him hating motherfucker.
Baby, I'm a whirlwind, and ain't shit hitting me.
You ain't doing nothing different. You ain't doing nothing different. Might got a little money, might do a little stunt, but you ain't doing nothing different. You ain't doing nothing different. You ain't saying nothing different.
Oh, like it like that. The way that ass shake and jiggle is so fat.
All right, welcome back to the Circle Atlanta Reunion. It's your host, Maddie Rance. I'm here with Jewel, Tevin, Alyssa, Dante. How y'all doing?
I'm awesome.
Hi, Maddie Rance.
Hi, hello. Welcome back. I got questions for everybody here. Y'all looking fabulous. I see you, Mama, got your hair wrapped up in the bling, a blue suit and a fancy shoe. I feel it. I already told you about your outfits. I'm not going to do that again. All right, let's get this round, everybody. Now, listen, Tevin... Jewel, you guys hit it off right after a meeting, honey. Like, what do you think it was about each other that drew you two together?
I feel like we clicked at ACTV.
Yes.
And throughout the season, it just grew and grew and grew. We live close by, so we hang out all the time. So, yeah.
Yeah, just automatic support. That's it.
It's that Virgo love. I'm telling you.
Period.
Okay. Alyssa, you mentioned at the beginning of the season that you were once a part of an all-trans girl group called The Secret Girls. How was your experience in the group, and where are we now with you and your solo music?
It's similar to being on The Circle. I feel like it was just very premature for its time. I don't think everybody was in it wholeheartedly, so... we had to part ways. One of the girls, Nikki, the creator, she's doing very well.
Okay.
I don't think the other girls are doing music anymore. As far as for me, I'm just, you know, I do what I love to do, and that's it. You know, I don't try to be more than what I am, and that's all I can be, you know.
Okay.
So with my music career, I'm just doing my own thing, finding my own sound, and working on a upcoming Latin album, so I feel like I'm just going to move my music into the Latin world.
Hey, it's all about the development. I'm here for that. Go on, Alyssa, keep that going, bitch. Don't you? If you can sing, don't let it go. God will take your blessings away. Okay, Dante, we saw you in the studio, friend, putting down a little track, a little cover or something, you know, a little body yaddy, but with your own little spin on it. How's it like being in the studio? How's that feel for you?
It felt great, actually, because I hadn't been in the studio for like 2 or 3 years before that. So it was kind of like, I think my last single I put out was like in 2016. So me putting this song out was kind of like, you know, I'm finally back in the studio. I'm getting it right. I mean, I'm sure I'm not perfect in the studio, but at least I'm in the studio.
Say you perfect, Dante.
No, I'm always perfect in the studio.
There we go. I need that confidence. C-O-N-fidence, okay? Thank you. With the music, where do you want to take your career? Like, where do you want it to go outside of being mega rich and owning a, you know, yacht off of Miami, popping bottles?
I feel like as far as my music, I feel like, honestly, I don't really take music that serious. I know when you're creating a song, you got to be able to put the best lyrics out. You got to put the best stuff out for even people who want to listen. So, I mean... I feel like my acting is my main career, and music is just something like a hobby, honestly.
Okay, how's the acting career going?
It's great, honestly. I've had a lot of great gigs after things that happened throughout the series.
Okay. I'm looking forward to those projects when we see them. Tevin, I dipped into your singing already, honey. I mean, you got the boots on right now. You're about to give us a five show performance, you know what I'm saying? Residency. When it comes to music for you, like we talked about before, where do you want to take that with your career?
I want to be successful in the entertainment industry, period. Music is something that I am not new to. I'm true to it. It's something that I've always done. And ultimately, I want to be just as successful as I can. You know, I want to be a household name. And I'm going to be.
All right, WTP, end of that track. Yeah, I want to be a household name. Y'all love that song.
Come on, household name.
Alyssa, we know you got a bit emotional during the season from the fact that Jewel said you could not attend her event because you are not Black. Can you walk us through how you were feeling that day? And do you still share those same feelings?
I said everything that I had to say on the show.
Thank you. Jewel, do you still stand firm on the stance that Black people cannot be racist? If so, why?
Well, that is a fact. Black people cannot be racist because racism and the act of actually being racist towards someone else means that you benefit from white supremacy, means there's power and privilege involved. Yes, we can be, thank you. We can have stereotypes, we can have prejudice, but to actually enact racism on someone else, no, we cannot do that.
Okay, so with this event that you had, and I understand that you were making it an all Black event, with excluding a cast member, you know, what was going through your mind or exactly when you decided to do that, you know, it could have made someone feel excluded or hurt. Like, tell me what was going through your head in that moment.
Yeah, so there were two events. One event I was hosting, and that was about the Harlem Renaissance.
Okay.
Right, so that is a time where we're celebrating Black excellence. And then the other one was an event that I have a ratchet room, which I did virtually because we're in a panorama. And that one, even pre the show, it's always been a space that exclusively centers the Black, queer, and trans community. Mm. And so for me, what's really important is to not get on this show and to not be authentic to who I am. It would have been very inauthentic for me to invite someone just because they're a cast member. So that was something that I wanted to be very mindful of. I'm like, okay, I know that I do Black events. I know that when I host, it's for Black people. I know that I'm getting on the mic with a ear. I'm here for my culture. So that wouldn't, cast member or not, that wouldn't be something that I would have done if the person is not Black. However, what was important for me to do, because I did not want for Alyssa to think that it was something personal towards her, I did reach out in advance and send a voice note and saying, hey, I'm not going to be inviting you to this event. This is the reason why. Because I felt like explaining it was so that she could understand that this is my politic. It's what I do. You know what I mean? I think that's very important when we think about that. So that was important for me to say.
Okay. All right. Now, I hear that, Jewel. Now, Alyssa, listen. I know I got a two-worded answer from you before, but I'm giving you this opportunity to speak because I want you to have a voice here, okay? Now, with Jewel saying all of that and you having that understanding, but still there may be a feeling of some sort of anything in reference for that here. Like, tell me, baby, like, where do you stand with that? Like, you're okay with it? Like, can we move on, or do you still feel like there's something?
I thought we moved on the show.
Okay.
You know, anybody that blocks me has nothing to say to me, so I'm okay.
Okay, so this is about a blocking situation?
No, this is because we have nothing to discuss. That's it.
Okay.
The storyline was that I called her racist and she doesn't want to be called that. Fine. Pick another word. So we'll move on. And that's what we understood. And that was it.
That's inaccurate. I did not block you or unfollow you. So that's actually not true. I went on the page and you had unfollowed me, which was fine. People unfollowed me all the time.
I unfollowed a lot of people.
Right.
But I didn't block nobody.
Okay. Well, I did not unfollow or block you, which is fine.
Everything I said was said on the show. And that's it. I don't have nothing else to say. There's nothing to say.
Okay. Hey, all right. I'm a... Do that for that?
No. After we shot the scene, I thought that there was a sense of, like, agree to disagree. And that's what I thought, which is why I did not unfollow or block her. However, after some other shows were put out and we shared different things, I'm hearing that you're no longer someone who wants to follow me, which is fine. And I'm being called wig and all these things. So for me... I just want to be very clear on that. So I get that it want to be a close, but I'm going to say the full story because that's important.
Okay.
I want to ask you, Alyssa, because I actually was at the ice skating rink and I consoled you, but I thought that you were upset because you had just lost a friend. I didn't think that you were upset at the voice note.
I was upset with a bunch of my emotions mixed together and a bunch of people constantly bringing up the topic. And racism is such a big topic in my life.
Okay.
So I did get emotional in that moment from a culmination of a
day. Right, and I even apologized to you at that event because I thought
really
that you were upset.
That.
You
but
know,
you also
at things that happened.
Said that you were going to reach out to me and say, you know, I want to get to know Alyssa more. And it was just, it's just weird how everything transpired. And that was it.
I don't remember saying that, but I didn't.
You said
have
it at the dinner.
That
you said that you would like to get to know me more and like
okay.
everything. And that was something that didn't transpire, which I'm not at all. I get it. I get the politics of the show right now, and I get mm-hmm. everything. I'm a grown person,
right.
and I can accept anything. Her and I moved on. Mm-hmm. That happened at the restaurant. Today, I have nothing to say. I mean, that's so behind me. I don't even.
Yeah.
So I don't know what we're fishing for here, but I really.
Oh, no one's got a rod. No one's moving into the water trying to find some fish here. I'm asking questions based off of what happened on the show, so we can get an understanding that maybe people didn't get the first time, right?
It was a lot of things,
yeah.
not just little nitpicking things. It was a lot of emotions going on, and it just got me in the right moment. And like I said in the very beginning, this is all new to me. I don't like this. You know, I'm a very shy person, and I don't want to be put in a box where I have to defend myself.
Yeah, yeah.
I shouldn't have to.
Your spirit, I'm.
I want to say something okay. because as a black person, racism impacts me every single day in a very particular way as a black person. And when this airs, people are very much going to be being upset with me, people who don't understand what racism is. Well, I just want to say
the racism
that ethnicity
wholeheartedly just as much
is
as you
Mexican,
do.
But people can, just there are white Mexicans.
Do. Just as much as you do.
There are white Mexicans.
Just as much as you do.
And when we
and
think
my
about
dad's
who
Vietnamese, so we get it just as hard.
Absolutely.
So
just as, you do not
it.
Get it just as hard as
we
a black
We get it hard.
Person.
We live in the same country. We get it hard. I'm actually way below you being trans. Yes, I get it way
okay, so
harder
talking,
than you.
Gender is different. I do agree for that as a
okay,
cis person. Absolutely.
So let's keep
we're
it
talking
moving.
About no. We're going to keep it moving when I'm ready to keep it moving, because race and ethnicity is very different.
Mm-hmm.
So people can be white Mexicans. So we're not going to say who's at the bottom of the totem pole. We're not going to do that. We're not going to do oppression Olympics. What I will say is that when I first met Alyssa, this was not on camera, but I want to be very clear. You can clarify or you can not, or maybe you can say nothing. But when I first met you, I literally said, hey, Alyssa, you know, just so you know, I did not know there was a person who was Mexican on the show. This is Atlanta. I thought everybody was going to be black. I want to let you know that as an activist, I'm an activist for the black community. So there's going to be events that I'm not going to invite you to, but I want you to know that this is me coming to you before any of this. And you were like, I understand, da 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 da. And like I said, everything people got into your head, and then now you didn't understand who I was anymore. If anyone goes on my page, if anyone Googles Jewel Cadet, they know my activism is rooted in that. And I told you that when I first met you. Did I not do that? Okay. We can move on.
All right.
So, Dante, I do feel like, you know, you were really coming for me online with my head wraps and everything like that. So I would like to know what the issue is with me, because when we were shooting throughout the whole season, I thought that you and I were cool.
But you, me wearing your head wrap is me just being an actor and me just portraying you as a person on the episode that aired.
You were mocking me.
Well, I said my name is Jewel the Gem. I mean, I didn't.
How did you say it?
My name is Jewel the
Gem. What did you have on your head?
A hair wrap, like you wore.
You were mocking the whole way I was saying it. And my thing is, this is an opportunity for you to now tell me, what did I do to you in order for you to disrespect me in that way? What did I do to
you? I never said you did anything to me.
Did I take a red marker and put it over your face?
No.
So all of this is stemming from after filming. And now we've started to, you know, people are starting to pick a little
well,
bit.
Well, it's a reunion. We're reunited, and it don't feel so good.
Quote the song.
You have disrespected me as well.
Okay.
Well, what do you mean how?
Oh,
if you say something disrespectful, bum-ass bitches, Tavis. That's the thing.
Oh, let's break it down for us, baby. What did he do that was disrespectful?
Well, let me be clear. When you say bum-ass bitches and you're talking about a specific group of people, you're talking about everyone.
Okay.
That picture that's posted and pictures are and faces are crossed out, that is being
very disrespectful.
And on top of that, every time I see you out, I've only embraced you, have I not?
Correct.
I've only supported you, have I not?
Correct.
So where's the issue? You weren't included in the part that we had. Is that what you're saying?
I didn't think it was no issue. I just felt like when y'all dropped the trailer and I wasn't in it, I knew that y'all had picked the side.
Well, Dante, we didn't put you in the teaser that was edited because you have been like this all
season. Flip-flopping.
So we can't show loyalty to someone that has not shown loyalty.
I didn't know we was on this show to pick sides. I thought we were on the show to be an actual circle.
It was divisive the entire season. And
correct.
We
and I was cordial with every
single
person.
No, you were not. You weren't cordial with both sides. You played over here, you played over here, you played over here, you played over here. You didn't have to do that. And I told you, I wanted to be more cool with you, but I don't trust you. And because I don't trust you, it is what it is. I can still be nice to you as I have every time I've seen you. But I've never disrespected you.
I mean, if you feel like you don't trust me, that's just your own feeling. But I felt like during filming, I definitely reached out to every single person. Even after filming, I reached out to Jewel.
This is true.
When I saw you outside, I had no issue with you. But what you did say was when the episode come out, you know, it's going to be whatever it is. And I'm like, okay. So
that's I said what?
When the episode comes out, then what, you know, it's going to be a different switch, and you already know what the issue is between.
No.
You didn't say that to me.
When did I say that to you, Dante?
I told you that when
the episode comes out, it's going to be a switch.
Yeah.
What was switching? I've already didn't trust you. I didn't fuck with you like that.
Right.
But I didn't have an issue with you. So what would have been the difference when the episode came out?
I feel like if you didn't fuck with me, then you wouldn't have spoke to me anytime you see me.
I don't have to fuck with you to be cordial to you. Every time I see you, you're by yourself.
So what's your reason? What's your reason to not fuck with me is the question.
Because I don't trust you. You are fake as fuck.
What am I fake for?
To be quite frank.
So let me interject here and ask this question. Because there's fake, there's I don't trust you. Give me something specific that he's done where that feeling has now impressed upon you.
If we have conversations over here, and when I say over here, a group conversation, and then you take a conversation back to people that have issues with the people that you had a conversation with,
you would talk to us, and then you would talk to the other side, and you would tell us what the other side was saying, and we were like, okay. So you were acting in that way.
What did I tell you that the other side said? I'm confused.
For me, Dante, I saw like, kind of like a little brother vibe. And when you would do certain things, I put you to the side like, Dante, that's not cool. So I'm gonna tell you right now, for you to go from being shaky to now you've made it very clear that you don't fuck with me. So now it's clear. So there was not no beef before.
I don't feel like I made anything clear.
You did. When you crossed my name out and you mocking me online, keep that energy.
Y'all started it, and then when we finished it, it's the issue. Y'all put the trailer out knowing that we're all on the same show, and you blocked half the cast out because of somebody else.
I didn't block you. I actually hit you up, and you was like, whack ass hoes. I'm a hoe, but I'm not whack.
I just unfollowed you like 2 days ago.
I told you to be careful, and then you unblocked me. You blocked me.
I'm going to ask the group to listen here.
Yes,
a moment.
Absolutely.
We're gonna come right back, babies, because we need to get to the bottom of this and some other things too.
All right.
It wasn't that deep for me, bitch. All I knew was invite Tevin.
For you to understand how I feel.
I'm telling you, I understand that, but that don't change what actually happened.
I'm not used to the gays, so I'm having to disregard it, and then I don't know you.
Well, who's the gays?
I'm not.
I mean,
a lot of in that bitch guns.
They asking why I'm so quiet. I'm just separating the real from the fake.
All right. Now, Cash, you mentioned that if you weren't passable as a black man, you would have been invited, and this is in reference to that event that took place, okay? You were very upset. How do you feel about it now?
I'm still upset about it. I think at the time when I was talking about it, a lot of cast members kind of, you know, wasn't relating or didn't resonate, and that's fine. It just to me, because I'm black and Puerto Rican, you know what I'm saying? So my sister, she's Mexican. So the way it came off, like, first of all, it's cold as shit outside, and we outside, you know what I'm saying? And then here's some fucked up shit that warmed me up, and that made me mad because I was like, well, you know, growing up biracial, you know what I'm saying? You have the black side of your family, you have the Puerto Ricans, and it don't, you know, people don't know there's a thing called mixed racism, you know what I'm saying? And I didn't like the comment because I feel like anybody should be able to come to your event, especially if you're talking about things with that have to do with your culture or who you are. And I said, well, thank God I'm half black and Puerto Rican, because then I wouldn't be fucking invited. What if I was just all Puerto Rican? Are you excluding Latinos out? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But then you don't want us to leave out the non-binary girls. You know what I'm saying? You don't want us to leave out the women, of, you know, the lesbian women. So don't do it with race or whatever. I feel like everybody, and that's when shit shifted. And I wish she was out here to explain herself, because I feel like that needs to be corrected. Sometimes people say some fucked up shit, and all you have to do is say, I was ignorant for saying it, and maybe it didn't come off right, but you gotta make that make sense. And then, you know, with some other shit that came out the line that I feel like, that totally pissed me off and turned my whole impression about Jewel totally off. And I still continued the night and I had a good time. I do think Jewel is a dope person. I think she just kind of so pro-black. She just, she's so godly, she's no earthly good. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes you gotta tone that shit down. To be heard is to be experienced, and you have to experience every motherfucking body. I don't like that comment. Until she come and say sorry publicly, then I might well like her. But other than that, she can kiss my ass, because I don't like what she said. And I think it's really unfair that everybody's out here. I really didn't like what she said, and I feel like she should fix that shit. So I think it's unfair that she can't face the world because she don't want to sit with certain people, but everybody didn't have a problem with her.
Okay, now we're going to move on from this here now. Now, we got a question from one of our viewers with the Circle Atlanta. Colin from Tampa, Florida wants to know, Tevin, could you ever be friends with Melly B?
Oh.
The thing with Melly B is I try to be friends with Melly B. And I think, Melly B, we have text messages. Hey,
boo. I don't disagree with that part. Okay. I agree.
Finish your
but
point.
I initiated that.
Because I didn't necessarily care for the way that he moved around certain situations. And I did come to him to have a conversation with him. And it was still like, well, you're going to have to ask somebody else. And it's like, I'm talking to you. I want to know from you. My thing with Melly B, as I said earlier, we don't have to like each other. But we can be respectful to each other. After we had whatever, we did not speak to each other anymore, and we've been in the same room with one another. I don't go around calling him bum bitches or broke bitches.
Because you can't.
Melly. Keep going, Tevin.
I don't do that because it's disrespectful.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's it. And we will never be friends if he can't be respectful.
What was I disrespectful? I'm confused.
Tevin, I'll say this. When I was told to invite you, one, I didn't want to do it. I ain't even that type of bitch. But two, because I still wanted you to be included, that's the only reason why I did it. And when I communicated what I communicated to you, I had no attachment to it. I didn't have any understanding to it. I did not give two shits of a lamb's ass. It wasn't that deep for me, bitch. All I knew was invite Tevin.
For you, you have to understand how I feel.
I'm telling you I understand that, but that don't change what actually happened.
I'm not used to the gays. So automatically there's a guard up, and then I don't know you.
Well, who's the gay?
And then
us.
Tev, I know what you're referring to. Y'all both say how you feel, okay? That is very true.
That is so edgy. Damn, girl.
So let's do this. Let's do this. Okay. We gonna go ahead and move on here, babies, because we got more to the show and other people that need to have time as well. But I'm glad that we understand that y'all can never be friends.
Mulatto mentioned earlier about the group chat, and I think that's where a lot of the division started to happen.
Well, that wasn't me.
So the group chat that y'all had together.
Like, it was something with Rico. Like, he put a group.
So Rico.
I wish Rico was here to have this conversation.
No, I think when Jules started that bullshit, when she said that that's when everybody, that's when the whole thing canceled.
What did Jules say?
Because she even said, after the group chat, we all still conversated. We all still went out. Everybody was still invited to everything. Everybody
we just wasn't in the same chat.
Never divided anything. No. That was just that one person.
Well, it did divide us in a sense, and it started a conversation of who should be and who should not be invited to certain events. So you already pushing people.
I didn't know that happened.
You already pushing people away. And at this point, hold on, let me finish. Let me
cash. Hold on.
At this point, I don't have an issue with anybody else. I'm just hearing, oh, you weren't invited, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah.
Well, that's his home.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think that was the only place that really
that nobody,
were
yeah.
not invited.
And that's the only
to,
reason
that was
why
his
I didn't
home,
do it.
You know, so with that being said, it wasn't nothing against anyone else.
Hold on, before you make it a side thing, I really want to say, so look at how similar things can be, how somebody on your side, 180, right? How Jewel would say she doesn't prefer right, Mexicans to be invited or to come to a black event. You know what I'm saying? Well, so how are y'all making this a big deal when we're telling you it was not a click?
This occurred before that.
Right, and it was not. What is explaining?
So
the thing is, it's the visual that causes the conversation. We'll be right back.
It's like I'm a witch. It's like I brought you back.
No, Sabrina, you didn't bring me back, Sabrina.
Sabrina, refer to me as the black witch.
No, Charmed, Phoebe Piper Page.
Those are white.
That's how I feel.
Give me more. Give me black people. Give
no,
me black,
Sabrina.
Because I call myself a witch, so.
Okay, Sabrina, then what's the point?
Headshot, little nigga, run up.
in my city, you have to come my way before you can do anything. So tread light. That's why I'm the prince.
Right, now Rico has joined us here. Hey, friend.
What's going on, friend?
I see you. Come on. That's a combat boot.
What's up?
Where are you going?
I'm just here.
Okay, that's all I'm asking. That look like I can climb walls and mountains, child.
And not be kick bitches, too. Yeah, but it's not that kind of party.
I'm glad it's not, because I was not invited. All right, so let's see here. Now, Alyssa and Rico, the two of you have known each other for quite some time.
15 plus years.
Ooh, how did the two of you meet?
I used to be a female illusionist.
He was in drag, sis?
Yep, when I was 19.
All right. What was your name?
Tanila Cassidy.
Ha ha, come on, Tanila. Don't deny you.
She was the team.
She was fun.
She was fun.
Okay. And this relationship y'all have had for 15 years, it's been nothing but growing good, y'all.
Yeah, that's my sister. Like, sister.
Not Tia and Tamara, though.
Tia and Tamara.
It is that.
It was like that.
We've just been through a lot.
We've been through, yes. Like, a lot.
I feel that. That's a good friendship, though, okay? Now, Jewel, in those spaces, why not allow someone who is of color to still be able to celebrate or to, you know, show support for the Black community and something mm-hmm. like that?
Affinity spaces are really important. I went to a women's college. People do a lot of things where they're saying, this is a space for certain people. So I have friends who are POC, a non-Black POC, and they don't attend those events because they're like, oh, this is not for me. I'll donate a ticket. You know, I'll support in other ways. So for me, having a space specifically for Black people is nothing wrong with that. We have Black churches, we have all those types of things, and white people have all types of stuff that's just for them. So for me, curating spaces for Black people is something that I do unapologetically.
Okay, I feel it. Now, Rico, listen, I know you came in a little late, babe. Mm-hmm. You know, around the corner, two mm-hmm. steps. Yeah, that part. Okay. Is there anything that you need to get off your chest or let us all know?
Yes, I have a lot.
Okay.
First of all, I would like to clarify a couple of misconceptions that happened throughout the season. Yes, I was the one who decided not to let them invite Tevin to the event because mm-hmm. I didn't want to be around that. We had just had an incident. We didn't speak after the ACTV event. I still felt some kind of way about some things, because when we did sit down, it was nothing but attitude, because after the event, we sat at a party and he basically just said, oh girl, it doesn't bother me. Mm-hmm. And that bothered me because you were rude. Your friend was rude. Martell was rude. I sat quietly and people sat quietly and watched your show. Y'all politely got up, went behind the curtains and started talking very loudly. I don't know if you were cocktailed, your friend was cocktailed, but it was disrespectful to me and my cast. And just to clarify, I was on the flyer, so I was scheduled to perform, unlike others. So I want to clear that up. And that it's a lie.
Let me stop. No. Before you
asked me a question. I'm going to finish, and you have the right. You have the right.
Okay.
He? I didn't say he.
You said she.
I didn't say. Did I say she? I clearly said he.
Okay.
But he asked me a question, so I'm going to clarify. And that it's a lie. It's the lie. Let me address you.
To the ACTV event that Rico planned. I'm so glad he
Rico
planned
did not plan that event. I'm so sorry to cut you off. That was not Rico's event.
But he said he planned the event.
It's a lie. Rico performed at the event. I don't think that anybody asked Rico to perform. I think Rico inserted himself.
You don't really go around saying that you could do something that you didn't. Just saying.
I did not speak to you at that event. I didn't know you. When we went to the other event at the brunching, the only thing I said was, hi, you're cute, and we took pictures together. I had no discussions about the ACT event with you at all. And for you to say, no, I did not, because I don't remember talking to you other than saying, oh, hey, what's up? And then them asking us to take pictures together. It's been proven that I did have involvement with that. So for you to sit on your platform and spew lies, both of you guys, about me, I have a problem with that.
Okay. After we got up from the friends brunch, you were like, oh, you wanted to have a private discussion. So then I was like with Tevin or whomever, and I went to you and I was like, hey, I know that you're upset with Tevin and Martell. I want to take accountability because I also was there and I was talking. You said, girl, I ain't mad about that.
at that point, I had let it go. If we did have that conversation, I don't remember that conversation.
Because I wanted to take accountability, because at the end of the day, I was also talking. I was meeting new people. It was a bar on the other side.
I understand, but so, for you, it wasn't that important on your behalf because you weren't a part of the program.
No. Even you if we told me it wasn't important.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. I made a very big deal about the comments you made on the web series saying that I had nothing to do with it. Talking about, it's a lie. It's a lie. When it was brought up, that I
the drama, the fake beef, you did
I don't
not
have fake beef, sweetie.
Oh, it was.
For
because
what?
You
for
were
what?
Cool with Tevin and Martell at the
ACB. Let me correct that.
So that was fake beef.
Those are called
so you to be like, you with it, you bad.
Those are called
those were your friends.
Those aren't my friends. Stop giving that.
They were your friends.
How are you telling me who's my friend? Okay. These are called
workers. Because I watched you at the
These are called workers. I do not have a personal relationship other than the fact that me and Martell did music together and we've talked and we've had sexual encounters in the past. Other than that, I never talk to them on a regular. Me and Tevin had just started really introducing each other that round before it started happening because of the Frenergy. And we sat and we watched. My first time talking to Tevin was when he did Frenergy and we watched the episode. And when I met him, I was like, okay, girl, that was cute what you did on the screen. We should do a show. We should do a crossover episode. These aren't my friends.
Can I just, one thing, Tevin? One thing. I just want to say, Rico, you on Instagram Live said that you were cool with everyone on the cast except for me.
Yes, I am.
So then what happened?
I'm not cool with you because how you treated my sister.
Oh, no, I don't care if you're not cool with me. I don't care.
But you asked, so I gave you
an answer. I'm saying that basically off of that comment, you're saying that you were cool. You was like, Tevin's my baby. Martell's my baby. So it is fake beef.
When was that?
On your Instagram Live. You should keep track.
No, you should pull it up because I've never said that about them.
Let me just keep track.
Are y'all following each other?
She's blocked just like she blocked everybody else.
Okay. Of course.
Tevin.
Rico. I talked to you after the ACTV event.
And that's when I said it was giving attitude, like you had no accountability for it. You took no accountability.
There is no accountability, and
you brought that person.
Hold on, Maddie. Real quick, hold on.
No, I'm letting you finish. Rico, give him a second.
Rico, I talked to you at the ACTV event myself after everything that happened. And I said, Rico, we cannot be showing our ass at our event. You said, oh, baby, trust me, I know what I'm doing.
Right.
Your eye. Okay, so if I had a conversation
with you,
at the ACTV event, if I talked to you right after at a house party, and then I saw you the day after that for a pajama party, and you sat right
pajama,
beside
no,
me.
No, I've never been into a pajama party, sweetie.
Oh, it was at Wesley's house. You weren't here?
What? That's when we had the conversation.
No, Rico, we had the conversation the night.
And what did I tell you? You didn't take accountability, and I said, okay, baby, whatever.
You called
That's
me.
A lie. I sat right there and caught.
Okay, look.
Girl, whatever. You can
I'm
say whatever. You're.
I'm a man.
That's a lie.
Whatever you want to say is
Rico,
whatever you feel. But when I talk to you, and I have people that I spoke to, and I said, well, he's still not taking accountability for what he did.
There's nothing for me to take accountability for.
Then, girl, why are you talking to me then? Then why are you speaking to me if you're not going
to
take accountability? Then quiet, mute, just like I text you. Don't talk to me then.
Rico, don't go there. And you, if you
where are we gonna go?
Thing,
where are we gonna go?
If you want to,
where are we gonna go?
Your ass gonna be in Fulton County.
No, baby, you're gonna be in Fulton
First
County.
First of all, you threatened me, and a police report has already been filed.
Girl,
Calm
if
down.
You can't threaten
there
me for a police
threat.
Report,
that's not a threat. You threatened me, so therefore, because we don't know each other like that, I am going to make sure that I cover my ass because we didn't have an issue. You called me on the phone during the season asking about a storyline that I was stupid enough.
Really?
You did?
Oh, I can pull up text messages where I got asked for questions. Let's not do the storyline thing because you did the exact same thing,
with
sweetie.
What?
With the show. You did the exact same storyline question.
What show?
You quit the show.
I didn't quit the show. I left the show because I'm going to Circle New York.
And then you came back.
No, I never came back.
You're here right now.
Because I have to finish this out because
it's
I'm going
like,
to
like
another
I'm a witch.
Season.
It's like I brought you back.
No, Sabrina, you didn't bring me back, Sabrina.
Sabrina, refer to me as the Black Witch.
No, Charmed, Phoebe Piper Page.
Those are white.
That's how I feel.
Give me more. Give me black people. Give
no,
me black
Sabrina.
Because I call myself a witch. So
okay Sabrina, then what's
I
the
got
point?
Your Prudence. You fine, Prudence. You fine. Uh-huh.
How are you not on the show and you here right now?
Because I was asked to come back by my side. They asked me to come back because they knew y'all would try to do a false narrative about me. Just like y'all do a false narrative with all this rah rah energy on y'all YouTube lives.
That you like to comment on.
Oh, yes. Because I'm going to, if you're going to talk about me, I'm going to defend myself.
Oh, good.
Who's going to ride you in the pre-show?
You.
Was I?
Yeah.
It wasn't your event.
We're not going to go back into that because I have several people that have clarified that I had parts in this event.
I didn't say that you didn't have parts.
I'm saying.
I never said it was my event.
You're Wesley?
Did I say I was Wesley?
Hey, you're not, you did not.
But when you watched the show, did you not see? I said I coordinated. I coordinated the event.
You did not plan it.
I coordinated.
You getting the location? No, because my thing is, Rico doing a lot of rah-rah now.
Well, you yelling at me, little lady.
Hey. Little lady, I'm 5'2", yes.
Yay, so what's the problem?
Okay, hey. My thing is, all of this is for what? You were a part of three scenes.
No, baby, I'm more than a part of three scenes.
No, you literally came back and then poofed you here. So yeah, my witch shit worked.
Obviously it didn't, because bitch, you got a problem.
Because you're right here.
I want you back. I can say the fuck I want to say.
I can call Alyssa, bitch.
Bitch, that's between you and her.
That's your sister. You protect women as a black man.
But if I'm disrespected, I'm disrespected.
It don't matter. You don't call another black woman no bitch.
Whatever I want to say, it's my mouth.
That means that you're disrespected.
If you're going to call me a bitch, call me a bad one.
You are. I've seen better.
Because we got pictures together.
Boots look good.
Because we got pictures together, Rico. And this is
I'm
what I'm trying to say.
Is that
don't be rah-rah. You know what I'm saying? When we to my face, because I heard you were talking about my wig.
Yeah.
So go ahead.
I posted up.
Go ahead.
It was back here.
Good.
You were saluting.
What happened?
You got bald hard today. I bought you some bald hair if you needed. I bought it today.
Nothing.
Well, you got it locked down.
Do you wear a wig?
You want to shift?
I did. So then don't talk about a black woman.
I can talk about. I can talk about a black woman.
Don't I can talk about a black woman.
What you gonna do about it?
And then you wanna fuck with a witch? Good luck,
girl. Do your luck. Sabrina Camp, all the girls you want.
Like
God
said,
got me, baby.
Who's a black witch?
God got me, baby.
Sabrina's white.
Girl, whatever.
Poof.
I don't believe you, bitch.
Poof.
Do what you gotta do.
Go. The bitch thing again.
Girl, what you gonna do? Okay. I can say whatever I want. I'm gonna
leave. You bad in front of bitch.
Bitch, you're disrespectful.
Stop being disrespectful. You can leave the bitch out.
We done.
I said I ain't got shit to say to you.
I said
you can leave me alone.
How y'all trying?
Anyone else? Because other people have stuff to say behind my back.
Don't matter.
Anybody else got anything they want to say to Rico?
No, I hope you get it all out. Okay. Do your thing.
I hope you got it all out too.
Do your thing.
Just don't mention me on live. Don't mention me on no more YouTube channels.
Let it go. Let it.
No, you let it go.
Let it go.
You let it go.
No, because I want to go to Cash. I want to go to Milano.
Let it go.
Let's go.
Let it the fuck go.
We reunited.
Me giving them a tour of the house, y'all saw each other.
He shouldn't have been there.
If you said that it was on site,
when
she saw you or when you saw her, it didn't happen. So for me, for you to leave, go out to your car, come back in the house, it seemed like antics. And felt like you put all of us in a position that we didn't have to be.
Look out for an all new season of The Circle NYC, season 5.
In a small circle, no room for your squares. Keep a small circle. See you below, way over there. What you doing, homie? Who you know from over here? I got a small circle.
And stay tuned for a new series, The Circle Down South.
We're doing this and we're representing Dallas. Like, I want to make sure that we set ourselves apart from these other seasons. Like, I really want us to be on our shit.
I don't need validation from the crew to tell you what I feel. I feel that it was negative, and that's why I called you on it.
The Circle docuseries, only on Our View TV, where our view matters.
There was an altercation at the retreat house. Jewel is not here to talk or defend the story. Does anyone wish to discuss what happened that night, or shall we leave this in the past?
Well, I have something I want to say, absolutely. Because everybody has their opinions about it, which they are entitled to. You don't know shit until you are that person in that situation. So if you can't have a moment to reflect and try to understand my side, I don't want to hear your side. Because you're not trying to understand. You just want to say whatever point and feeling that you have. And that is fair, but I won't accept that.
Okay.
The situation with B-Hawk and Jewel is, well before that day happened, that's when me and Jewel had our altercation where we acknowledge that her best friend was someone who has been threatening me. So fast forward to the retreat, for this person to now be in a home, we all received the call sheet. B-Hawk name is not on it. B-Hawk is also not on the show. Mm-hmm. So for someone who has been having different interviews about me constantly slandering my name, and said it was on site when they saw me. So for them to be standing in a home that I'm walking in with my bags, my suitcase, a bottle of Grey Goose, and a whole half for everybody. And I'm walking into a situation where I'm supposed to be comfortable enough to shit, eat, and sleep. Mm. And you have someone walking around who's there to, she flew here in the middle of the pandemic to be in a home where I'm at and is calling it a surprise transphobic attack when she was the only person that was a surprise. Mm. You're not on the call sheet. Why are you here? So for Jewel to even bring B-Hawk to this situation, is you wanted something to happen. I come in a situation ready to have a good weekend with everybody, regardless of where we were in that situation, because all of us are able to have conversations with each other to figure out whatever we want to, if we want to. Mm-hmm. But that was not a situation that was supposed to be like, oh, peace. And anybody who thinks that is delusional. And I left. I tried to go away. I tried to deal with it. Megabody at some point came in, and his energy was a little off when I arrived too with Cash. And so I had a moment where I was like, what the fuck is happening? I just got here. Why is all of this happening? I really did try. He had no business being here.
She had no business.
She had no business. And everybody keeps thinking that is intentional. And
I know it's not, but that's why not. I had to say it, because you do, yeah.
Yeah, but my issue is don't check me like you the police. That's a problem. Mm-hmm. You know, because no matter how I feel about whatever I feel, I'm still not going to say, Megabody, I don't like that bitch. Da-da-da. You know, I'm going to say it a certain way. It just, the communication with me never was that. I've tried. A lot of people came into this season acting like they didn't know who I was, like they didn't watch previous seasons, which is crazy. Why would you join a show and not watch previous seasons?
I didn't.
That's fine. That's just my opinion. Like I said, I don't want to argue it about it, but my opinion is I've been here. I've done my due diligence. I didn't come in attacking nobody. Mm-hmm. To call me transphobic and I'm friends with Alyssa and a lot of other trans women, it's crazy. To call that a surprise sneak attack when I'm on the cast is beyond me, and that's just not fair.
Okay, and thank you for saying your piece on that, Melly. Now, I'm gonna go move over to Megabody here because there was involvement in this from you. I just need your feelings on the situation.
First of all, I just came to have fun, had me a drink. Yeah. I was not here for any of it.
Well, you was a little rah-rah when I got
well,
here.
Well, let's go there first. Okay. So the reason why I was a little rah-rah, because I come into the house and room arrangements have been changed per certain people in the house. I ain't with all that. I'm just as much a cast member as you and anybody else.
I didn't know
show.
Anything about
you. You didn't have anything right. to do with it. You're wondering why I was at, you know, okay, kind of a little off. That's why. Okay. So don't interrupt.
No, because I know you think I did.
So it didn't matter who did it.
Who caused the issue?
I believe Dante was the one that started switching names, so I started switching names. That's, yeah.
Dante.
I didn't do it.
No. But you was giving a little edge.
No, because you was like, I want this room. Why are y'all in this room and stuff like that? And
I didn't say I wanted the room. I wanted to know why y'all had a personal room.
I don't know why we got the room. I just was, my shit was already in there, and I was told if you wanted to be in that room, you would. And I said you wouldn't move my stuff, and I meant it. You know what I'm saying? It was nothing bad.
And what did I say back?
I mean, it can't
I said if I wanted to be in the room, I would be in the room. Period.
It was that energy for me.
Period. Because the same way he's claiming that nobody would move his stuff is the same way I'm letting y'all know when nobody gonna move me.
And I feel like that's what contributes to that general assumption that everybody thinks it's us against y'all, and everybody plays on it.
Well, he had that shoulder lift and all that.
If you wasn't that, you wouldn't have came at it like that. You'd have been like, "What's going on?" I feel like for it to be right away, y'all ready to have a attitude about something.
He was giving very much shoulder shrugs. Don't do that with me.
Okay.
Do that with everybody else. Don't do it with me.
I'm like this all the time, and you're saying shit like I am. I'm not going to change.
Which is why
you told me that you could take the room. I said you're not going to move my stuff.
Which is why you know I'm not that guy, and don't do it.
And neither am I. And I have no problem with you, but you brought a lot of energy that I got there. I was the first person there, so of course I knew what my room was. So when Dante came and he switched all that energy should have been directed towards him. I didn't make room to raise. Matter of fact, I wouldn't have preferred to be in that house.
Dante wasn't giving me all of that.
Right. And just let me ask this question before I get back to you, Mega. Dante, not to even like be like, your fault, but more
it
so.
It is. It was.
No, let's not do that. Let's just ask, why was the name changed in the first place?
I feel like when I walked in the house, like I said, I was already the second person. And if I'm going to sleep in a room with somebody, I want to sleep in a room with somebody that I want to sleep in a room with.
So this
Dante. And I feel like at that time, me and Eugene was actually cool. Mm. So I said, well, actually, let's sleep in a room together. But when Megabody came in, I guess he felt some type of way about me and Eugene having the same room together. Mm. I guess he wanted to do a switch when I didn't understand when he didn't even stay in the house.
What I felt was, because you don't have to speak for me, I'll speak for myself.
Okay.
What I felt was it should have been done fairly. Room should have been picked a certain way.
What does that look like?
Maybe pulling out a hat. I don't know.
Oh, okay. I was about to say, shit, how the fuck
I don't think that anyone should get special treatment. So, I'm a cast member.
Well, I did it. We had a nasty-ass room.
Y'all had a whole damn space, and everybody else was on top of each other. I was not there for that. Even though you're right, I wasn't staying in the house.
Okay, so... And so for you, it felt like preferential treatment.
It did, and I wasn't here for that.
Okay.
So none of us was aware of that feeling.
Or right. The situation. And I didn't give Dante any fever. I just started moving names.
Yeah, but Cash with the B-Rock situation Cash and that the, going on, it was like.
Cash is the one that kind of gave me a little rah-rah, and I'm like, wait
a
minute, Cash.
No, you started the rah-rah. I'm more light than dislike. If I'm going off, it's because you have provoked madness out of me. I'm already waiting for everybody to show up. Mm-hmm. And the whole night was fucked up, it to was. Say the least. Mm-hmm. I don't have a problem with Megabody. I've known Megabody longer than anybody on this cast. So if the rooms was a situation, I understood that. Mm-hmm. But when you tell me, a grown-ass man, you're going to take my room where my shit is already, where I'm considering, okay, let me be here.
I said, if I wanted the room, I would be in
there. But it was too much cocky for me, and it didn't have to be that way.
You said something about
don't figure out who's in the room, and right. It had nothing to do with the quantity in China or me. So that's why he got the vibe. Other than that, I had no problem. After a while, we went our separate ways through the house, and until that shit escalated. But other than that, it was not a big deal.
I played the same game that Dante was playing. It wasn't a big deal. Yeah.
The call time was already like an hour before. Nobody showed up except Cash. So when I showed up, I'm going to select my own room. Like, I mean, who would it?
Well, it didn't matter because we didn't spend the night there nowhere. So,
and I do want to apologize to everybody, my side and that side. I'm sorry, y'all. Apparently, it's real. But because I'm not a violent person, I spent several seasons where people were constantly attacking me. And if anybody watched those seasons, you saw me go through that. And I never resulted to violence. I handled what I needed to handle. However, when you come for me in real life and ain't no fucking cameras, you three seasons behind me, and you're constantly threatening me and bothering me, there is no footage of me threatening B-Hawk. There is no footage of me calling anybody outside of any trans anything as far as hate. I run my own company for 8 years. I have a lot to defend. I walk around with certain things for my defense. I don't have no man running behind me. Everything that I do on my own. So when anybody continues to threaten me and bother me, and then you pop up in front of me, you can't expect me to be okay with it. You can't expect me to be civil.
And
that's
from
not
my
fair.
Experience, me giving them a tour of the house, y'all saw each other.
He shouldn't have been there.
If you said that it was on site,
when
she saw you or when you saw her, it didn't happen. So for me, for you to leave, go out to your car, come back in the house, it seemed like antics. And
I felt like you put
all of us in a position that we didn't have to be
well,
in.
Well, that's what I'm apologizing for.
I know,
because I understand it. Well, B-Hawk then came down to the basement. Why are you? It's a taunt.
I wasn't taunting you.
I'm talking about B-Hawk.
Well, I brought B-Hawk down there.
Wanted to fight you, Megabody, and she was circling around you, bitch. What the fuck do you think about
that
happened next?
Well, it wasn't a circle around, and I think that when we came down there, you may have thought it was a taunt, but it wasn't.
I didn't discredit how you felt. You can't discredit how I feel.
No, I'm not.
What happened?
I'm not.
Y'all
I'm just saying.
Completely just
I'm saying
that.
I gave them a tour. I came up with giving.
He shouldn't have been.
I asked them if they wanted a tour.
I just don't understand why it has to be that, because it really don't. We all black.
She came. I feel like she should have came the last day. I feel like it was so much that we needed to
do as a group together.
Yeah.
Cash and Melly B threw a party and invited bad bitches only. Martell, why weren't you invited?
Am I a bad bitch?
This is true.
I'm so sick of you, Martell. Let me tell you the point.
No, wait, no, you did, but you didn't invite me. No, Melly B did invite me. We talked about it on the
Yeah, because you was at the studio or something.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, like I had
everybody wanted to make it.
I couldn't come because like because unfortunately it was the day of.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to invite everybody, but there was so much happening. Let me tell you, this season is different. I may have been a lot of New York. I'm a lot of Atlanta, but all these bitches got a lot of shit going on. So there's a lot of shit that I did not know about. I still do not know about. And a lot of that was, I feel like people focus, they think it's me. Anybody associated with me, it got to be Melly. It got to be this type of energy. And that is not what it is. I really don't be thinking about people at all. But I just feel like, you know, with that situation, it was difficult to figure out who we gonna invite. I had to hire.
How do you start talking? He asked my pal.
Well, I'm just saying, bitch, it was the truth. I mean, it was my event. But you know.
So because it said the Circle Atlanta reunion party.
But it said bad bitches only.
I'm not bad.
No, I'm joking. I'm
probably the baddest one on the stage. Okay. But so I was like, you know, at first I said I wasn't going. My dad offered to come pick me up. It's like I'm not going. So then I thought about it for a little while. And then I was like, hey guys, we were in a group chat. I was like, hey guys, we should go. Martell said, no, it's really far. I let them know we're not going to be there that long. I definitely didn't think that we were going to be there that long. So they agreed. We got dressed. We came out. Oh, Jewel said she wasn't coming. And it was no drama. We went up the stairs. It was security. Melly B said, no, they can't get in. We turned around, walked away. Cash started talking shit. I wanted to know who Cash was talking to. So I was like, hey, what's up? Like, who the fuck you talking to? Because I just knew it wasn't me. And I want people to be specific.
So this is what I said.
Hold on. I just want people to be specific when they talking to people. Don't make a blanket statement because that includes me.
Right. Right.
I made this comment to the party that was there over the music. I said, hey, y'all, raise your hand if you go somewhere that you ain't invited to. Make it make sense.
It was a and flyer nobody, that was out.
But the whole not. Thing, it wasn't out.
I saw the flyer. And I probably still have it in my phone.
Hold on. At the time when I said it, he was like, Cash, who you talking to?
It didn't say invite only.
Well, baby, since you heard me, I said what I said. You should have came. You know what I'm saying?
Like, and what did I say?
You said you'll show me something. I said, well, show me, baby. Okay. And I
want you to come on downstairs so we can talk about it.
Well, you know, we've seen each other since then.
How about you don't support violence? That sounds a little violent to me.
Listen.
No, he told me he was going to show me something, but we've seen
what I was going to show him wasn't going to be violent. How about that? It was going to be the end.
Lord. Well, I've yet to see it, you know. And you I don't want to really see that.
You can.
You know, not from you.
You can. You can.
Thank you all for an amazing season. You were able to become amazing friends. Okay. Thank you for opening up your lives to the world. And thank you for watching The Circle Atlanta Reunion. I'm your host, Maddie Rantz. I need a drink.
Come on for the drink.